So when you talk about valuation, I think a sound and reliable methodology needs to be in place, particularly for assets such as wine, which is it's a tangible asset for which there isn't an official listed exchange. So for this, each month, we have an independent third-party press aggregator. We collect prices from this company, which is called Wine Owners, to pull prices from the various wines that we hold in the portfolio. And then we transmit these prices to the administrator, who independently validates the NAV on a monthly basis. Clearly, our goal is to deliver an accurate appraisal of the assets that are in the portfolio. And where required, always use the most conservative approach. So just to illustrate this, we're recently finalizing the audit of 2014 with Deloitte, who obviously dissects all the valuation of the assets held in the portfolio. I think it's worth mentioning that out of the lot, there were six wines for which we decided to apply a director's override. And what this does is that where we find that the valuation is not reflective of the current market price, or where we have a question mark, we do reserve the right to amend that valuation. And again, using the most conservative approach, we decided to value these assets at cost. Just to give you again a sense of the magnitude, these director overrides only represented 1.2% of the portfolio. So we believe that we're sticking to our philosophy of having a robust, transparent, and independent valuation process.